Good evening, 17th December. We basically, what are we repeating? What is the Python is best suited for? That is for the machine learning work. What is machine learning? Machine learning means that you write a core software, small software, that will learn itself from the test data. Because right now, lots of data points are available. 10-20 years back, that not data is available, labeled data, that means this data means this particular, these images is type 1 cancer, these images is type 2 cancer, or not only cancer, you can take any data. So, because this so much data is available, so if you can feed the data to an intelligent program, the intelligent program will learn itself and then give a more better rather than if you hand code the data, if you hand code the program. That is the machine learning, and machine learning, Python is the number one. There is no other programming language can do this. The first thing you have to understand, what is two things. One is, what is regression, what is classification. I think you last class I have done it. Just regression means the output would be a continuous variable, say output would be a real number, floating point number, or it's a continuous variable. And classification means yes, no, very good, like this. And there are also various methods to calculate, like these are the typical decision trees, perception, artificial neural network. All these models are built in Python. Regression is also, if you want to carve, if you have the data points and this is, you put a scatter plot, and you can put a straight line, and you can put a straight line with the so that minimum square error is minimum square error. You know the error has to be positive and negative, so that is the reason it has to be square, and variables should be minimum. It can be better fitted, maybe not with a straight line, it can be fitted with polynomial, and that polynomial equation can be found out by the Python library. So linear regression is the simple best thing to learn, first the regression, then the classification, and these are the more sophisticated regression problem. Regression problem is output is again is a output is a floating point number or certain continuous, and it is a classification problem. Like, let's see the, I think this will be more clear. Like regression is what's the temperature going to be tomorrow. If you have the past meteorological data and you want to predict regression, like all the weather forecaster does, and right, and the classification also, whether it's a hot or cold, like this is a two things. Yeah, another way of looking at it, like classification is whether it's a green ball, maybe the tougher data set, maybe one green ball can be here, then curve will be like this, or maybe one green ball here, one red ball will be there, then there will be definitely, you cannot put a like clear distinction, so there will be some impurity will be there. And regression is like this, you put a not a straight line, this is not linear regression, this is a polynomial curve, I am fitting it to it, this is it. This is a basic distinction between regression and decision. Yeah. Is it visible? It is understandable. Like another way of seeing it is like if you, the linear regression cannot be fortunate, so that all the data line cannot be onto it, like but generally data line will be this thing. So I will fit the straight line, it does not have to go to the 0-0 line. So I will put the straight line here, like here, and where the RM is square, right? But if you put a perpendicular on it, and that is the error, that you have to square it and plus it and minimize it, then this straight line will be automatically gone. This library, this linear regression library, it is a simple function, you have to just call it. You have to, you just import scikit and import linear regression, and you just run this. This is linear regression, then you also polynomial regression is also there. Yeah, there are two differences, a tree model classification where the target value is a discrete set of values that I have told, and dependent variable are all categorical. Categorical means like yes, no, male, female, like this. This is called categorical variable, teacher, student, library staff, these are the categorical variable, and regression, you know, the target variable is a continuous, typically real numbers. This is another way of looking at it, classification regression problem. Now, this is last day I have discussed little bit of this is machine learning. The machine learning starts 50s and 60s it has started, but right now it's very fast stage. The first stage is you have to understand whatever we have discussed, it is the supervised learning. Supervised learning is that you have a data set, is available, labeled data set, and you learn to it either regression and problem, then where you need to predict the continuous output like temperature or the market value of a particular flight with flat with certain locality or three-bedroom and all these things that I have discussed in my last class. That is the regression problem. Output is a continuous, and another is classification. Classification means whether there be hot temperature or cold temperature, like I have shown, whether there is a cancer with these images, which type of cancer, not only type 1, type 2, type 3 cancer like this. These are the called supervised learning. You have different techniques are available. All these techniques are all built in the Python. So you don't have to rewrite the code. What the thing is that you should see the problems right now, and so many data sets are available, and free data set, like if you want to work COVID-19 related data, like right now the people are working vaccination data, how you can better vaccine the whole society, which way, there's so many data are available, and you can compare the values with the different parts of the world, all the data are available, and data are in their site, and you just simply, you can get the data, and you have to put it in a pandas library, and you have to just put it into pandas data frame, numpy and pandas, and the whole data set is available, and then you can work various learning technique like supervised learning technique. Then I'll come the unsupervised learning technique. When you are making a classification, if it's already without teaching it, if already make classification there, even without teaching, without label, that is called clustering. That is difference between classification and clustering. Classification is supervised, and clustering means you give the data, and data automatically learn itself. It's shown very futuristic, but unsupervised learning is very hot topic, and most of the postal digit zip code detection technique in USA and in India also, it is done by unsupervised learning technique, from handwritten recognition, digit recognition. The unsupervised learning, they can learn itself. So this is it. So there is a then the more sophisticated is reinforcement learning. Reinforcement learning is quick learning. You have to take the steps, and within each learning, you don't have to say yes no like classification, or you don't have to say exactly output like regression. It is basically you have to learn by itself. Whenever in our childhood we learn by whenever you are born, and within 6 months, the child learn by itself by touching the various objects. Then whenever after one year or 1.5 years, you are then again learned by your parents or your neighborhood, where the neighbors are like this. But when the first learning is a reinforcement learning, that the child learn itself. So whether our program can learn itself with the data, so that is one of the techniques is going on, and it's very sophisticated technique, and there are some tools are available. These are tools are available in the import SciPy, and I always follow this import SciPy, and always follow the version with this form, with this string. So anything like NumPy or pandas, you do this for anything. From SciPy, you can do all the calculation that I have given in another video. Whenever in SciPy, all your mathematical, all solved equation, everything will be there. That I have already told you. That all, like your NumPy only give minimum, maximum, average, that's all, a median. But with the SciPy, all mathematical equation can be done on the SciPy. I covered this one. This is the this particular thing, the runtime. Every cell, how much time it given? It gives this. This is, I always tell that Colab, you can also share your experience because I found that if you load import wise command, then you can go for import threading. It will get the which process IDs. It will give a certain other feeling that remote machine is working. So I prefer this. So this is kind of a debugging also. If problem, sometimes the long lines of Colab gives a problem, then you can work in a cell and that particular cell is working, you copy, then in another cell you separately test your code there. If it is okay, then again you copied it back to the original cell, and each cell after the running it will give a time, then you can see how the good. I think it's it depends on you how to debug, and you can always I always prefer this whenever you say import matplotlib, you can pretty well be there, but I want which version and let it be pinned. So I am sure this matplotlib is loaded because it is very silent. If you put it in a verbose mode that it is loaded and all these things, even it will help you. This is it. There is not, yes, that last is programming plus C, and this all this program is all this there in my YouTube. Today I don't want to repeat, just I want to share you this one. Keras, particular site Keras, you search it and there are lots of code problems are there, computer vision related, all types of, not only computer vision, image classification, even the text classification, your from your voice image it can detect you. And let's see if you can go to the particular site. Yes. Yes, I think it is better to shoot. This is the I want to teach you the Keras, and these are all codes are given in Python. The basic Python, whatever you know, that's good enough. You already know NumPy. SciPy is same like this, and the reference, you know, the NumPy is basically is a contiguous memory location in RAM. The physical RAM may not be your machine, it may be remote machine, but it is a contiguous. It is written in C and C++. It is pretty fast. So it's a huge kind of NumPy. NumPy given another advantage that you can choose your which kind of data. It can be character, it can be 8-bit integer, signed, unsigned, or 16-bit. So you can granularize and specify your data. If you know your data type, so you can make it 8-bit integer or 16-bit integer. That is the great thing about the NumPy, and huge area you can do it. And whenever you go to next class, we invite you to for Tensor. What is the advantage of Tensor? There are two packages are there. One is PyTorch. We try to work on PyTorch. It is developed by Facebook and it is being supported in Colab also. Right now, most of the machine learning work, deep learning, machine learning work is done by PyTorch and TensorFlow 2. TensorFlow 2 is provided by Google, but PyTorch is given by Facebook. Facebook also give lots of good input to the society, I believe, other than the social networking and all these things. There are some debatable things are there, but the, unlike Apple, they give some technology like Google. Google is mostly giving the technology like Colab and all these things, but Google, one good thing about it, their TensorFlow or PyTorch, they have given it, they have supported PyTorch. You might ask what is PyTorch is. PyTorch is nothing but is a extension of Python. What is the problem? What is the thing is that nowadays GPUs are 10 times or 50 times faster. GPU means graphics processing unit. There your numerical arrays can be work much more faster. Like what is the limitation of NumPy? It needs only CPU. It cannot work on GPU. So that is the reason the PyTorch is developed, and you can work the same NumPy array on a GPU, which is 10 times faster, and GPU is free. So you can, that is the reason I will tell you to suggest go for Colab and you get GPU free. Some of your advanced laptop might have NVIDIA GPU. My laptop doesn't have NVIDIA GPU. I have, whenever I bought it 2 years back, I cannot envision it. It is a different GPU and doesn't work. So if you procure laptop nowadays, or if you have a desktop, new desktop, you can go for NVIDIA GPU. It is not pretty costly. It is, NVIDIA GPU is available from 4,000 to 18,000 to 20,000 rupees. You can attach it to desktop. Unfortunately, probably laptop you cannot attach, whatever I am aware of. But whenever you buy the laptop, you go for NVIDIA graphics so that you can work on GPU and you can do your coding using that GPU. And but if you even have, don't have GPU, you don't have to limit your code on your laptop. You can go on code in your Google Colab. Google Colab will give you the free GPU and free TPU, Tensor Processing Unit. Tensor is another, Tensor Processing Unit is also giving me free. Only thing is your contact time will be only 12 hours. I think computer vision, these problems are there. In natural language processing is another interesting area in machine learning, which can be done by Python. And structured data, time series data, audio data is speaker recognition, like your all the smart speakers and all. Generative deep learning, these are all reinforcement learning, quick, these all these programs are given. Okay, it's written Python and it is available on GitHub. You please see one of it and you can work on it. I think that will give you a good chance for coming various hackathons or any project ideas. There are some various competition are going on. These are taken from this. With this, I wish to end today's evening. Thank you very much for staying with me. If you have any question, please put the question. Please make your group. Okay, and those who have given the first project, please be ready with the extension of the project or make a new project with. I wish that you take the project with the Python, NumPy, SciPy, and PyTorch. PyTorch, I will start in the next any group, and that is available. Thank you very much.